Well, hello. My name is Harry Braun, and I am an independent 2020 Democratic presidential candidate. I'm a Democrat because I'm the author of the Democracy Amendment to our Constitution. But I don't consider the existing so-called Democratic Party Democrats, because they're not Democrats. They're Republicans who call themselves Democrats. But the definition of democracy is two words. Those two words are majority rule. It doesn't mean elections. That's part of it. But in our country's case, we have completely invalid and corrupt elections done through computers, where a single company that happens to be run by some very right-wing Republicans counts the votes in secret in 42 states. And very few Americans I know, that I talk to, know what the name of this company even is. And it's never mentioned on any of the major news networks that I watch, which is principally CNN, NBC, MSNBC, and Fox. So those are the basic networks that I follow. They don't mention it. In fact, they keep mentioning, they have these so-called experts who keep saying that they have people that, so-called experts that say no major fraud occurred in the 2016 election. Except this company counts the votes in secret in 42 states. And according to a 2018 investigative report in the New York Times, where an expert was hired to take apart one of these machines and really look at it, they found that remote control access had been installed so that anybody from this company could use their laptop to hack into that computer election system and manipulate the votes in real time during the election is what they were doing, flipping votes in real time. And this expert found all this. The New York Times reported on it in 2018. And yet that story has been ignored. And yet I keep hearing these people saying that you'd be sure to go out and vote, but the same company is counting the votes in 2020. The name of that company is Election Systems and Software. ESNS is the acronym. And the fact that they're counting the votes in secret in 42 states is no minor concern. They've been doing it at least since 1990. And in 1994, they flipped the Senate from the Democrats to the Republicans. And once the Republicans were in control of the Senate, they've been able to pretty much what I would call destroy the country, because they empowered Donald Trump to become America's first dictator, who refuses to acknowledge the Congress, refuses to acknowledge subpoenas, and he has taken over the Justice Department with his Attorney General. So we ineffectively are now governed by a dictator in the United States who refuses to have any kind of transparency, who's fired all of the attorney generals, he's fired all of the inspectors generals, and anybody who was investigating him, because he is one of the most corrupt people on the planet. And he's gotten away with all of it because of the terrible flaws in our Constitution and the way the current Congress operates, because they don't follow the Constitution in many cases. But in this case of what do you do, no one's been able to get rid of Donald Trump. The impeachment was a fiasco for in large part because Trump's most serious crimes against humanity were never even mentioned by the Democrats. And what were those crimes? Well, those crimes involved taking all the regulations off of the oil and fracking industry. I'm sure you probably heard that. Oh, isn't that wonderful? We got rid of all the environmental regulations. Oh, great, so now we can poison our kids even more than we already have. And fracking involves poisoning aquifers forever for a fracking site that doesn't even work 24 months. Poisoning aquifers forever is a Nuremberg class crime. You get hung for that kind of stuff. It's worse than murder. Who has the right to contaminate aquifers forever for a little bit of natural gas when you never needed it in the first place? Because Hydrogen fuel has been available since, at least in terms of humans, and I say that because the proteins and the biological organisms on the Earth have been using hydrogen for everything to stay alive for the past 4 billion years. Hydrogen is critical for survival. It's, for example, when hydrogen bonds to oxygen, you get water. And you can't have any life without that either. So, we have a highly corrupt government run by what I call the oil industrial complex of corporations that own the major banks. They're so wealthy. And they own the major television networks, which is why you don't know anything about the hydrogen age, which is the real solution to the climate change and the chemical contamination and the economic problems that we now have that are all spinning wildly out of control at this point. And that's not even counting the pandemic that is raging all through our country. This is a truly biblical scale event because this is not just a normal virus. This is a very new and dangerous and vicious virus that is not bothered by 110 degree temperatures. This is not a seasonal thing at all. And this virus attacks the bodies in ways that the flu looks like minor by comparison. And yet we had a president who claims all the credit for saving millions of lives when he was the person who actually dismantled the only pandemic infection control team that we had in the United States that was established by President Obama. But because Trump didn't like Obama, he just dismantled the entire pandemic infection control team that could have stopped that virus before it ever even got to the United States. That's what it was there for. But Trump just got rid of everybody, said we didn't need it. If Obama did, it must be bad. So he got rid of it. So all of these dead people right now, and all of the people that have been crippled for life because of this disease, are because of Donald Trump, who is a technically illiterate person who doesn't know much about anything other than talking dirty and being a gangster type person, which is what he is. So, and yet we can't get rid of him? Well, I've often said Donald Trump is a pathological liar, and I could never understand why anyone in our country, how any voter could tolerate a pathological liar who's technically illiterate on top of it. I mean, when he advocates trying to inject bleach into people as a disinfectant in terms of dealing with the virus, how stupid can you be to even suggest something like that? I mean, it's off the scale stupid. Now, I admit I'm a scientist, and I work with thousands of scientists and engineers. And let me just tell you, we don't have any problem at all knowing what facts are and what's real and what isn't. Politicians, though, I'll tell you, they are the problem. And I hate them because they don't tell the truth. They have manipulated words so that you don't know up from down, depending upon who's in charge in terms of which party's in power. And it's been warfare, vicious warfare, and all of that will end with this democracy amendment that I am proposing to the voters. Now, amendments are normally not able to be ratified by voters. They have to be ratified by state legislators, who would never ratify a democracy amendment like this, because it's going to put the majority of voters in charge of approving anything the federal government does. All of our legislation, all of our presidential executive orders would all be required, and I might add Supreme Court decisions, would all have to be approved by a majority of registered voters in our country. That's at least 60 to 80 million people, depending upon how many people are voting. That would be a universal mind that has the final say on all of these issues. And that will end the partisan warfare the minute this is ratified, because political parties will no longer be in power. It will be the majority of voters. And they're going to make lobbying illegal. Because who would want your elected officials bribed, mostly by the oil industrial complex, because they have more money to bribe people than anybody. So they're, if you want a big donor, you suck up to the oil and fracking and nuclear people. They're your big donors. Well, All of that would end in a real democracy that I'm proposing with this 28-word amendment. And the key with this particular amendment that I'm proposing is that we're not using the approach of going to the state legislatures to get it ratified. Because Article 5 of our Constitution, if anybody ever bothered to read it, and by the way, it's not a very long paragraph. It's a short paragraph. You should read it. Because in that very short paragraph, it states that, and it was this, it's called the Emergency Clause language, put there by a founding father named George Mason from Virginia, who now has a university named after him. And George had a passion about this. The Constitution's all been pretty much written at this point, but he's had this passion about giving the voters an emergency cord to pull if they needed to. If you got a dictator type person that got in and you couldn't get rid of them, you've got to have something that the voters can do to get charge of, take control of their government. And that is in Article 5. And here's what it is. It's very simple. What he, meaning George Mason, got, the language he put in there was that, yeah, you can use state legislatures to ratify amendments, but because of Mr. Mason, the voters, he put a provision that voters can ratify amendments in what would be called constitutional conventions for the state, not a national constitutional convention that's also mentioned in Article 5. You can hold a national constitutional convention and do anything. And people are afraid of them for that reason. You don't know what's going to come out of a national convention. But the state constitutional conventions in Article 5 do not have any authority to do anything other than ratify amendments that have been proposed. And Article 5 clearly states it doesn't matter where the amendment comes from, who comes up with it. What matters is whether or not the voters in 3/4 of the states, that would be 38 states in today's world, when they ratify the amendment, if they ratify it, then it's law. That's the key. So, most voters have no idea of this incredibly, it's the most important political power in the Constitution for voters. And they don't even know it exists. And I'm not a lawyer or a professor of law, and I hear professors of law keep saying we're a constitutional democracy. And I wonder what law school they must have gone to, because you don't need a law degree to know the United States has never been a democracy. And our founding fathers knew damn well what a democracy was. And they viewed it, many of them, as mob rule. They were a bunch of rich white guys who basically didn't want to deal with the common man. What did they know? And so what they wanted to do was deal in the back room in secret with the money people, the lobbyists. So they did not establish a democracy, a majority rule democracy. They established a republic. And if you think a republic is the same thing as a democracy, you need to get yourself a dictionary and read it. And you need to understand the most despicable governments in the world are republics. Like the government of Russia, the government of China, the government of North Korea, the government of Iran. They're all republics. Israel is a republic. They say it's a democracy, and they're all lying. And all of the Democrats, so-called Democrats, and I say so-called Democrats, because if they were really Democrats, they would be operating in a democracy, and they're not. They're operating in a republic. It's to the republic for which we stand. Well, the republic is run by lobbyists and oligarchs, billionaires, oligarchs, it's all the same thing. An oligarchy is ruled by rich people, and that's pretty much what our government has always been. It wasn't the common person. Their voters don't have any power to do anything. Oh yeah, we go to vote, and supposedly gets counted properly, but we haven't had a valid election in this country since I've been alive. And there's no reason not to. In fact, the beauty of this democracy amendment that I'm proposing is that it's so simple to do. You're going to be amazed at how simple this is for the voters. All they have to do is be aware of this move on the constitutional chessboard in Article 5. And basically, this ballot is what you download from my BraunForPresident.us website. When you download this ballot in the comfort of your home, you will fill it out. Put your name and address in there. There's the amendment at the top. Here's what it says, 28 words. We the voters hereby empower the majority of American voters to approve all federal laws, legislation, presidential executive orders, and judicial decisions that impact the majority of voters. That would be all of the Supreme Court decisions. And then there's a paragraph explaining in details how we're going to shift from an oil age to a solar hydrogen age, and we're going to live in harmony with the planet instead of contaminating it. And then when this when you basically sign your name at the bottom of the ballot, you're going to mail it to your Secretary of State's office, because that's who has all the voter registration data. And if your particular state wants you to mail it to your county election, then mail it to your county. But the Secretary of State is the principal, and this right at the top says this is an Article 5 state constitutional convention citizen ballot. That's what's at the top of this ballot. And once you sign it and you mail it off to the Secretary of State's office, you haven't had to leave home. You don't have to stand in any long lines or put up with any of that nonsense. And then when the Secretary of State's office gets this, they can very quickly validate that ballot with your name and address. And then they can count it, archive it, scan it to a computer database so that the voters can actually go to that encrypted database and check and make sure their vote was properly counted and recorded. That's the kind of valid, credible election system we can have. And that same system of downloading simple paper ballots that are super inexpensive to do compared to anything else. That's the system that will be used for when the voters have, when it comes time, there's a bill before the Congress and the voters have to make a decision. Then they're going to use the same paper ballot system. For example, when right after we ratify this amendment, the voters are going to hold an election with paper ballots like these that you download. Not from my website in that case, because the amendment will already be ratified, the majority will now be in charge, and they're going to make sure the Secretary of State's offices in all 50 states, they will be the ones who basically produce the ballot, allow it to be downloaded, so the voters don't have to go stand in line. They're going to just download it at home, just like we do this one. And then the voters will mail that back to the Secretary of State's office, and that we're done. It's that simple. And every time a new law or a war or anything comes up that's important that the voters have to approve, right now we're going to, because there's no way to do it safely with computers, and cell phones are computers. So if you think voting on your cell phone is convenient, it is. But it's also not right now verifiable. And so the fact that they can hack into encrypted files is such that let's just keep it simple. Voting isn't that, this is a simple thing to do, is download a ballot and mail it off. And we don't do it that often. And we want to be able to document all of this. So I'm the only person running for president that even understands this part of the Constitution. And I'm not a lawyer, mind you, but I am a scientist. And I do know what words mean. And for all these people, including these professors of law that say we're a democracy, they're lying to you. They're too smart not to know that we're not a democracy. I don't know why they say it. I don't know why they do. But I do know this. We got enough lying going on in this country. And I don't believe lying should be legal in our country. I don't think every time Donald Trump makes one of these, he ought to be in jail for all these lies. They're so obvious and blatant and stupid in many cases. I mean, suggesting people inject bleach. The guy is really not playing with the full deck, but that's the fact that he is unable to be touched by anyone because the Republicans have protected him, just like the Nazis protected Adolf Hitler. And there's no difference, except Hitler just destroyed much of Europe and killed 40 million people. Trump is killing the planet. This is the end of all life as we know it, according to thousands of scientists in the world. If you haven't been listening or paying attention, it's because these television news networks don't cover this story. Because they're owned by the oil industrial complex. They set up these little shell corporations, put, I'm talking about the oil companies, they got lots of money, they put money into a little shell corporation, XYZ, and then go buy a controlling interest in CNN stock. And the next thing you know, CNN's pushing oil company ads and so-called documentaries on how good fracking is. And without telling you, they're poisoning aquifers forever. That is the problem. CNN is owned by these people, and so is ABC, CBS, and NBC. These television networks are strategically important assets that the oil companies can afford to own and control. They own and they keep people stupid with that garbage network and commercials nonstop. Those are public airwaves. Those belong to the voters and the people in this country, not to a bunch of rich corporations to brainwash people every day 24/7. We need to get control of those corporations and not let them be running amok like this, because they're killing the planet. This is the only planet in the universe that is able to sustain protein-based life, and we are killing it with oil-based hydrocarbons. Not to mention the radioactive isotopes that are now coming down in the rain worldwide every day. And there's not just a few of them, there's over 360,000 different species of oil-based poisons that are now in the rain. Poisoning everything. All of our crops, all of our people, everything. And you never hear about it on the news. What kind of a news networks do we have? You think the corona COVID-19 virus is a serious thing, and it is. So is having the rain contaminated. You can't even touch it. And you don't have to take my word for this. Google contaminated rain and see all the scientific papers that will come up. This is serious business we're in. And this democracy amendment is the only way out. If we don't put the majority of voters, who happen to be women, if we don't put them in charge, we have no hope of saving our planet. And we don't have much time. The good news is the scientific world that I represent, which is made up of thousands of scientists and engineers in the world of hydrogen energy. And these scientists and engineers represent NASA, for example, because hydrogen fuel is used by NASA for all the moon rockets, because it's the lightest fuel there is in terms of energy per weight. And it's the safest one to use. And it produces no toxic carbon-based emissions, zero. And we can modify your car, your home, your cell phone, skyscrapers, aircraft carriers. The aircraft carrier would literally be floating on its fuel source, the seawater. Got electrolyzers on the inside of it that just electrolyze the waters to separate the hydrogen and oxygen, fly the planes. The aircraft carrier never runs out of fuel and doesn't need it because it's sitting on it, floating on it. So. It would revolutionize just about everything and clean up the entire planet and save humanity, not to mention even the proteins that are being wiped out because of all these oil-based poisons. And the oil industrial complex has an army of lobbyists in all 50 states. So that's why the state legislature is never going to ratify this amendment. And I'm the only person that made you aware of the emergency clause language. It's the most important power that voters have in Article 5 of the U.S. Constitution to ratify amendments like this democracy amendment with wartime speed, long before the next hacked and phony election in November. And I will, in future broadcasts, talk about my views of Mr. Business as Usual Biden, because he's been working for the oil industrial complex his whole political life, because that's where the big money is and he knows it. He's been pushing fracking worldwide, along with Hillary Clinton as Secretary of State. That was their mission one, because that's where Exxon and Chevron and Halliburton were, and the whole thing over there in Ukraine, that was all about fracking. But you don't hear that on the news, do you? No, they don't want you to know the truth. But I only deal in the truth, as best I can determine it. And if I ever have anybody correct me, I'll be the first to acknowledge it if you show me I'm wrong. Because that's the way scientists are. I deal in hard data, and I know what I'm talking about, and I represent thousands of truly brilliant people who've been working on this their entire lives. This goes all the way back to the year 1800, when the world's first automobile wasn't running on gasoline because it didn't even exist. It was running on hydrogen made from water with electricity, from a battery that was made by a brilliant physicist from Italy named Alessandro Volta. We never needed oil, ever. We never needed to poison our planet and our people, ever. It was all for the profits of capitalistic oil companies. And they are exterminating all life on the earth if we don't stop them. And we don't have much time left. So, you need to help out. Your job is to download this ballot. Go to the braunforpresident.us website. It's right on the homepage. Download it. On the back of the ballot, you'll have Article 5 right up here at the top of the explanation here. You can read it yourself. There's the emergency clause language is in red, so you can see what I'm talking about is real, and it's in our Constitution. It only requires the voters in 38 states to download this ballot, and then we, the voters, are going to be in charge. And that will be finishing America's revolution. It was started in 1776, but got sidetracked into this bribery-based republic by the rich guys. And it's time to make that change. And, you know, they were they rich white guys? Yeah, except, let me tell you, I'm a scientist, and I want to make this point that they were not white guys. There are no white people anywhere on this planet. And I think we need to stop talking like there are white people around. Everybody in biology is a shade of brown, except there are some people who you can define as black people, and if there are some people like that in the United States that you could define as black, but there are no white people anywhere, ever. My shirt is white. I am not white. And I've seen white polar bears. I'm sure you have too. White rabbits, but no white people. And I think it helps, you know, this whole concept that skin color has anything to do with the substance of an individual. It's absurd. It's unscientific. It's just like President Barack Obama, his mother was so-called white, his father was so-called black. So why is he black? He's got half his genes from both parents. Well, do you see how stupid this is? The mere fact we're even have this racism is all based on crude ignorance. It's just, it's disgusting. And it's what the Nazis were doing. And now we have a Nazi as president who loves the Confederate flag, for Christ's sakes. He's not even, he doesn't hide who he is. And we shouldn't let him stay in office another day. He's a Nuremberg class criminal that we need to have arrested and tried before we put him in jail for the rest of his life, because it's too easy to hang him. But you know what? That's going to be up to the majority of voters. Because I can't do anything unless we get this amendment ratified first. Even if you elected me president, if we don't have this amendment ratified, I wouldn't have any power to do anything against all those lobbyists and all those members of Congress who just say, screw you. We're not gonna do anything you say. Because that's the way they are. We have to have this amendment ratified first. And then, frankly, it doesn't matter whether I'm your president. Well, actually, it does matter, and here's why. I was going to say you could have anybody because the majority of voters are going to be in charge. Here's the one thing you have to remember, though, about being in charge. You got to know what to do. And frankly, I know a lot of voters, and they are as confused as Trump or Biden about what to do. Biden's big deal is electric cars. He thinks that's the solution because he doesn't know much. He doesn't know that lithium-based batteries are a rapidly diminishing resource worldwide. And that when you mine lithium to get it, you devastate and destroy entire ecosystems forever for the lithium that's not going to last very long. Half of the lithium in the world has already been consumed by the cell phone industry. And now we're talking about all the cars? getting into that too? That means that the lithium age is going to be short-lived. And by the way, it's very dangerous if you get into an accident. Compared to hydrogen, that's super safe because it's the lightest element in the universe and doesn't form explosions and burn you alive like gasoline will do. So what we have to do is focus on getting this Democracy Amendment ratified. That is the most important thing that can change everything. But you also want to have a president that knows exactly what to do, that's based in science and doesn't keep secrets and doesn't hide in the back doors and keep everything, you know, you can't know what I'm doing. You need complete transparency in that office of the president. And because when the voters are in charge, they got to know everything. You can't keep secrets from the voters when they're in charge. So this concept of government secrecy and bribery is going to end, and we're going to run the U.S. Congress like the Navy is run, and the Army, and the Air Force, and the Post Office. That's how we're going to run our government, with honor and no bribes. Now, I've seen a Harvard University poll that you can check out online that says 84% of the American voters, of both Republicans, Democrats, as well as independents, actually hate our government. Oh, what they hate is the money in politics, the Orwellian partisan warfare, where depending upon who's in power, they completely reinterpret whatever they think they want to do. But the bottom line is the oil industrial complex owns both political parties. So it doesn't matter whether it's Hillary Clinton or whether it's Donald Trump or Joe Biden. They're all working for the oil industrial complex because they're all working for the big donors. We got to get the money out of politics. Fundamentally, make it illegal. Put people in prison if they get caught taking bribes. That's what we're going to do when we ratify this amendment. So, you need to get excited, get fired up. We got to save our planet, and we got to do it right now. Every day counts. So, go to my website and download that ballot and do what you can to get this message out. If you're a Facebook member, it's critical. We got to get this to go viral on Facebook, and I'm the first to admit I'm not a Facebook person all that much. I do have posting on it, but I don't really like Facebook all that much. But I do understand that Donald Trump focuses on Facebook. It's a very powerful entity to cover it. It's not my expertise. I could use your help in that regard, getting this message to go viral. Because as soon as it does, the voters are going to take charge. It's going to happen really fast. It's going to be a revolution that's going to change everything really fast. And we'll be driving all these cars on hydrogen before you know it, and we'll never see air pollution ever again. It'll be crystal clear skies forever because the air coming out of a hydrogen-fueled internal combustion engine is cleaner than the air that goes in. The hydrogen age is vastly superior to this oil age in every way you want to look at it. You just need to learn about it, and that's why I'm here. And this is all about education more than anything. And now that you understand the power of Article 5 of the Constitution, and how we can ratify this Democracy Amendment with the voters. Once you get that, get on board, do whatever it takes, and if you want to make a donation to our organization, please do. If you can't afford it, that's okay too. I understand it. We're in this pandemic, and there's a lot. We've got a lot more people out of work than they tell you on the news. This unemployment rate isn't anywhere close to what for example, the Bureau of Labor Statistics reports that there's over 100 million Americans who are completely off the books, that aren't counted on the unemployment rolls because they are called chronically unemployed. They live in an underground economy. 100 million people who they don't pay any taxes. They're in a cash economy, living what must be a very desperate type of life, close to the edge. And imagine if they haven't been able to work for a month or two. When they've been living check to check, or job to job, or however they survive, I don't even know. But those people are completely off the books. If you factor them into the unemployment rate, those 100 million people that we don't count, we just ignore them, and their children, well, now you've got, in terms of unemployment rates, you're over 40%, not 10%. So, we really do need an honest government, and we need it fast. So we can turn this around, but it's got to be a we. I've done the research for you, and I'm here to answer any questions that you have. But you, the voters, now once you understand this, it's up to you to help make it happen, because I can't do that without your help. So you be sure to get in touch with me, and you can always send me an email to HB, as in Harry Braun, at braunforpresident.us. And if you want to become a guest on one of my broadcasts like this, we can do a split screen interview where we're going to use Skype or Google Hangout, and you can ask me the toughest questions that you can possibly think of, because I'm looking for tough questions. Because I'm completely transparent about this. I represent thousands of brilliant scientists and engineers in the world. I've been an advisory board member of this engineering society since 1980. So I'm certainly an expert in the subject, and we don't have any time to waste. Our Earth is dying, and it's going to take some heroic action to save ourselves. But at least I know precisely what's going to be required to do that. And it's going to be involved in transforming your homes into hydrogen homes that are going to not just become energy independent, they're going to grow their own organic food indoors inside your home. Your home is going to become an ecosystem where you've integrated both plants and aquaculture, fish, in a completely balanced way, to where the waste from the fish, i.e. the fertilizer, isn't waste at all. It's organic fertilizer from the fish that's used as nutrients for the plants. And so it's a complete ecosystem inside your house, which will transform the inside of your house to a kind of Garden of Eden that's going to be super healthy to live in. Because right now the quality of air in your house is terrible. It's typically 60 times more toxic than the outdoor air, because everything inside your house, from the paint, the carpets, the clothes, you name it, is made from oil. And it's all toxic. And it's all outgassing and shedding all these terrible poisons that you're inhaling, and your kids and and now that you're living in your house and you don't want to go outside, you've got to open the windows and air it out as much as you can. But when you have all those plants in the house, they're going to transform it. You'll be like living in a Garden of Eden kind of thing. So this is what we have to do. Every major building needs to be modified to do this, not just your homes. And there are buildings right now in New Jersey, for example. There's an entire skyscraper of indoor agriculture. It's the coming thing. It's the thing that we can survive in, no matter what happens with this climate change chaos. If as long as we let the scientists have the necessary authority to do what needs to be done. There's no confusion. There's no R&D needed. Everything is here now. We just need to get control of our federal government, and we can do it with this democracy amendment. So please make it happen. Make it happen soon. Thank you very much. Grow.